Hello and welcome to our daily devotional for Wednesday the 10th of March. I'm Jeremy, a member of the ministry team, and we're up to Psalm 132 in our series through the Songs of Ascents. Before I read it, let's pray together. Heavenly Father, would you use this time to shape our lives by your word? In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Let me read Psalm 132, a song of ascents. O Lord, remember David and all the hardships he endured. He swore an oath to the Lord and made a vow to the mighty one of Jacob. I will not enter my house or go to my bed. I will allow no sleep to my eyes, no slumber to my eyelids, till I find a place for the Lord, a dwelling for the mighty one of Jacob. We heard it in Ephrathah. We came upon it in the fields of Jar. Let us go to his dwelling place. Let us worship at his footstool. Arise, O Lord, and come to your resting place, you and the ark of your might. May your priests be clothed with righteousness. May your saints sing for joy. For the sake of David, your servant, do not reject your anointed one. The Lord swore an oath to David, a sure oath that he will not revoke. One of your own descendants I will place on your throne. If your sons keep my covenant and the statutes I teach them, then their sons shall sit on your throne for ever and ever. For the Lord has chosen Zion. He has desired it for his dwelling. This is my resting place for ever and ever. Here I will sit enthroned, for I have desired it. I will bless her with abundant provisions. Her poor will I satisfy with food. I will clothe her priests with salvation, and her saints shall ever sing for joy. Here I will make a horn grow for David and set up a lamp for my anointed one. I will clothe his enemies with shame, but the crown on his head shall be resplendent. So we have the people of God making their way to Jerusalem, to the temple, on pilgrimage. And this would have been one of the songs that they would have sung along the way. And it starts with the people of God crying out that the Lord would remember David, that he would remember all that David did in preparing for the temple. You might recall that David himself didn't build it, his son Solomon did, but David did an awful lot to get ready for it. And they are crying out, saying, Lord, remember David, remember him. That's in verses 1 to 5. Verses 6 to 7, we see that the people have come from all the villages around on this pilgrimage and are making their way to that temple, that very one that David prepared and Solomon built. And you can imagine perhaps amongst the crowd the sense of excitement and expectation as they head there for the festival. Verses 8 to 10, let me read those again. Arise, O Lord, and come to your resting place, you and the ark of your might. May your priests be clothed with righteousness. May your saints sing for joy. For the sake of David, your servant, do not reject your anointed one. So on their way, they are making a plea to God, saying, come to your resting place, verse 8. May your priests be clothed in righteousness, verse 9. May your saints sing for joy, verse 9. And in verse 10, do not reject your anointed one. This is what they're crying out to God for. And then immediately we get the response in the following verses. So do you remember that plea? Do not reject your anointed one in verse 10. Well, immediately in verse 11, we read this. The Lord swore an oath to David, a sure oath that he will not revoke. One of your descendants I will place on your throne. Affirmation of what God has promised. And in verse 12, we read that that came with the expectation that they would keep the covenant. They were also crying out to God to come to his resting place. In verse 8, you might recall that. And verse 14, this is my resting place for ever and ever. Here I will sit enthroned, for I have desired it. Do you see? So there's that cry, Lord, come to your resting place. And then they immediately, in a few verses afterwards, encourage each other with that affirmation of the truth that it is the Lord's resting place. It's what he has decreed and desired. And then they also cry out, Lord, may your priests be clothed with righteousness. May your saints sing for joy, in verse 9. And then further on in verse 16, we read, I will clothe her priests with salvation, and her saints shall ever sing for joy. So it's a lovely example of the people of God crying out and then immediately really affirming what they know is true, what God has promised and intends to fulfill. And it would have been a real encouragement, I'm sure, for them as they were singing this and heading to the temple. They're encouraging themselves with what God has said in the past. They're remembering the promises of God and looking ahead with hope. That comes in 17 and 18. Let me read those verses. This is how the psalm finishes. Here I will make a horn, that is a king, grow for David, and set a lamp for my anointed one. I will clothe his enemies with shame, but the crown on his head shall be resplendent. So this is how the psalm finishes, looking ahead to that fulfillment in Christ. And we do well to equally remember the promises of God and look ahead with hope, as we see the people of God doing in this psalm. So we should be familiar with the word of God so that we can trust him through the ups and downs and changing circumstances of life, so that we keep in step with the Spirit of God. And we too are looking ahead with hope, that sure hope that we have in Christ. Let's pray together. And if you've got the St. James Prayer Diary, inside it tells us that today, the 10th of March, we're praying for St. James Kids. Pray that families would be growing together in faith as they read the Wonder of Easter family devotional. So let's pick that up in prayer. And also on the back, we have a list of the countries from the Operation World Prayer Calendar. And today the country is Bhutan, a very small Himalayan Buddhist kingdom, very isolated actually, a population of less than a million people, very few Christians. And those that are there often have a hard time. They do face persecution. So it's good that we pray. Let's pray together now. Heavenly Father, thank you that because of Jesus, we can belong to you. We can trust you. You keep your promises. You are totally trustworthy and faithful. And we thank you that that's the truth. Help us to keep trusting you, to keep living in step with your Spirit. And we ask that all those working through the Easter family devotional will be encouraged by the sure hope that Easter gives us. We pray too for your people in Bhutan, that even when hard pressed, they would stand for you. And we ask that in that land, you would open spiritually blind eyes and soften spiritually hard hearts, that the gospel would bear fruit to your glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.